You got the sword. You got the bow. He pulls a little bit out of the decks. I don't blame him wanting a little bit of that extra defense. Mm-hmm. Ulgrim hits hard.
It can be very dangerous. It can stack up quick, especially with that axe. It does a lot of damage per hit, and that is something you got to be careful of, and that's what Blue's kind of going for with that extra defense. But anyway, off the bat, already getting a lot of this damage with sword. Started out, Mem for Mini with the lance, trying to get those aerials off, but Blue already forcing the edge guard game, but not forcing the edge guard super hard early on, backing off. He knows that if he goes too hard on a lance, especially off stage when it's trying to recover, he can get caught in something, get a lot of damage built up, and that can be very dangerous. Ooh. And that was very close to something very big there from Ember Mini, but Blue making his way out.
He's got to build back that damage. He's on the back foot right now. He's deep in the red already. Blue looking for the kill shot with those signatures, but Ember Mini not giving it to him.
Blue with the pop and bop with the bow, the down light neutral air, looking for those pop and bops. Oh, goes for the neutral air this time. Tries to get the pickup for that high aerial play. Finds the down sig though for the kill, and there it is. Blue taking the advantage here. Only in the orange, he's got a little bit left on that life to work with. And I think the last weapon that Enfermini got caught with was lance. So the next one we're seeing him pick up should be axe.
He's not even getting a chance to pick up any weapons. Blue just starving him, switching between the sword and the bow. Enfermini finally arms up with the lance. There it is, not yet enough to get the kill shot. Go off the edge. Oh, looking for that recovery. That's all he needs. Maybe the axe can do it. It does have harder hits. There it is. Pulls out the second one. Swipe the double. Get him out of here. Tie up the stocks two apiece.
Oh, and he gets bopped in the head on the falling lance as well. That's unfortunate. It could have been something super devastating on a Blue, but Enfermini wasn't quite ready for it. I don't think he was expecting someone to get hit by something like that. Blue now with the sword, popping him up, getting the juggle going onto Enfermini with those neutral airs, the recoveries, and the recovery popping him up real high. He's got the damage going, and there's the side zig. That's the confirmation on that kill. And now Blue holding onto that sword, now swapping between the two, looking for that bop. No, Enfermini playing beneath him, looking for these unarmed startups, but Blue doing a good job at kind of spacing out that center of the map, holding that map control.
Yeah, and you know what? I like his rotation back to the sword. This is where we've been seeing him get a lot of that early damage to push into the red. Even though he's been getting all these different signatures for the KOs, a lot of that early damage has come from the sword.
Mm-hmm. Blue already getting a little bit more damage here, playing that spacing game, trying to avoid that dash inside light. Combo starter from Enfermini. That axe play can be devastating, and no one knows axe better in EU than Enfermini. So this is going to be a dangerous game for him to deal with, but Blue holding onto that edge guard, doing a great job, and there's the ground pound, finishing off that game. Two stock, taking it down. Blue taking game number one, and that was actually a pretty quick game overall.
Oh yeah, commanding performance. I mean, you even saw it in the damage numbers.
Yeah.
He did almost close to double the damage that Enfermini did, and just absolute stage control the whole way through.
And that's one of the best things about utilizing the sword with its versatility, holding that center stage, being able to use all that different versatility on holding that center stage, make them approach you. You have the high ground, Anakin. Anyways, he was taking full advantage of all of that. Enfermini, though, trying to bring it back, run it back into this map. I actually missed the map pick. We got Thunder Guard Stadium with the shenanigans zone in the middle. Enfermini going to try to swing things around this time.
All right, I do like this map pick. You know, Enfermini, the lance off stage, it's a bit of a wild card. You know, you can get caught out really early, lose a stock. It's easier to edge guard against a lance. But Thunder Guard's got tons of avenues to get back. He could get to that side wall with the horizontal movement with those side airs. He can pick his way back to stage.
Blue doing a good job at avoiding some of this damage from the lance. Some of the grounded work, though, coming out from Mini. Very good damage coming out in that shenanigans zone. Not able to find a finisher or a pressure starter. He's still just launching him horizontally in that area in the shenanigans zone. Good damage, but not. I mean, you got to get him below the map or way high up in the air if you're going to build that pressure. But Blue now taking advantage of it. That down air can just force a lot of pressure and doesn't connect it. Caught him halfway through. Wasn't able to get him quite high enough.
Now, what's going to be very telling here is if Enfermini can extend this stock, it's going kind of the same way that it did last time. He's already in the red. Blue's only in the orange. Enfermini's got to make his stand here on this stock.
Now, Olgrim with his lance signatures are kind of unusual, but I would actually say some of that timing wouldn't... It could possibly throw out Blue. Now, this is a completely different game, and I'm not quite on their level, so I can't really say, but... Maybe I just want to see some of the signatures come out. I do love me some Olgrim signatures. But anyway, Blue taking that kill off onto the right side. That, I think it was just a neutral wipe for the most part that took it out.
Yeah, just so much damage going on to M for Mini. Blue just finding hit after hit. Great dodge escape, getting out of that axe string. Escaping the shenanigans zone. Doesn't want to go in there with M for Mini. I mean, we saw him pour on a ton of damage last time they were both down there.
Yeah, those wall combos can be insane, especially on Lance, especially with Emperor Mini being extremely comfortable on this axe. You got to be careful with this positioning, and Blue is very mindful of where he is, and now getting stuck in that shenanigans zone, but able to get out. Emperor Mini is giving a lot of respect while down there. I don't think he wants to get caught by that sword on the way out of that zone, and ooh, a nice option trying to get the anti-approach with the neutral stick, but Emperor Mini finding that side air, finding the kill as well, evening up the stocks. Is going Emperor Mini's way right this second.
And look at him just juggling those weapons, forcing that next weapon spawn to come out so late so he can just get so much damage on. Axe versus unarmed, Emperor Mini had the clear advantage.
Emperor Mini spacing himself out, playing a little bit slower than we saw at the start, and now it's working out for him a lot. This is where Axe shines, when you have that map control, and you can take a full advantage of that grounded combo starter game, just force them into the air constantly, and force their approaches all through the air, you chase them down and everything on stage. That's where Axe shines, and Blue right now taking that map control advantage. The bow is going to carry him miles right now, as long as he can hold that control.
Man, Blue going again for that stomp. Hit up that floorboard looking for the KO, but M for Mini, you know, he's kind of catching on. He's picking where Blue is looking for these KO shots. We see M for Mini going for a lot of that down signature on the axe. I think that's his favored way to close out a stock.
Mm-hmm. Blue making his way back. Not afraid at all not having a weapon in his hand. He just goes in, gets that recovery kill off the top on Emperor Mini in his last stock now. But Blue is actually pretty good at a pretty good distance in the red himself. So Emperor Mini, all he needs is something with a lot of force behind it, and he can find a kill. But Blue right now doing a fantastic job extending that stock out. But the recovery from the lance is going to be a little bit much for him to handle as he gets taken off the top.
I mean, you know what? Emperor Mini, he timed that well. He is not far behind. He's just in the yellow. Olgrim's got pretty good defense, so he can definitely bring this back if he gets a couple of those more axe strings.
Blue looking for that approach right now with the bow. He's got the spacing advantage here, so he can, as long as he's grounded, he can really get on top of him for Mini. Mini now trying to find his way back on, but oh. Blue giving him no room to work with. And trying to get that edge guard, but he's going to get caught by the recovery on Emperor Mini's side. And there's a recovery on...
Just enough.
And that's 2-0.